intake manifold gasket came with these the coolant port restrictors that the Edelbrock intake manifold doesn't even have anything back there, so don't have to worry about these. I guess I'm gonna leave the EGR ports open. Just gets everything kind of hot. It doesn't really help much. And I'm just not gonna worry about it. I'm just gonna leave them open. So here's the same Edelbrock Performer we just took off. I cleaned it up, believe it or not. This still looks pretty grungy. It has some silver paint on it and it didn't all come off. It really needs a media blast or something, but we're just not gonna worry about it. I did get out this broken stud with the welder and tap the holes down. And I actually widened these since the 3/8 inch threads were kind of stripped out. I had shoved a metric bolt in one of them to make it fit and get it tight, but no more. These are 7/16 holes now, and I already widened the holes on the thermostat housing, so with the 7/16 bolts, everything works perfectly. Brake clean and shop towels. We'll clean up this gasket surface, put a little bead of RTV around the coolant ports, put a nice thick bead of RTV on the front and back, slap the gaskets on, bead of RTV around the coolant ports on the other side, slap the manifold on. And we'll do the same thing on the intake manifold. Now I'll put just a little bit of RTV around the coolant ports. Try to lay down a nice bead across the channel wall. These gaskets are symmetrical, so they also don't matter which way they go on. So we kind of squish it into there, lay it down. Try to get it lined up with everything, press it in just a little bit. And get a little more RTV on this side of the gasket. We could take a bit of time with this since we know the intake manifold fits since it came off this thing before. Which, by the way, you definitely want to check beforehand before you put all this RTV on here. Now it's been hanging out here for a little while. I'm gonna go ahead and try to get this straight on there, first try. All the bolts except the frontmost and backmost need thread sealer. The front and back are blind holes. If you noticed before, I hit a whole bunch of washers and stuff on these bolts, so they weren't quite the length I wanted. So I ended up just cutting all these bolts short while they were all out, mostly so you don't have to look at all the washers anymore. Front and rearmost ones, just get a little bit of oil. And fingers crossed on my funny spacer bolts get in correctly. So the camera's battery keeps dying and shutting off, which is not helping this time-sensitive process go any easier. But the four center bolts did go in easy, didn't fight, and everybody seems happy. So now we just need to go around and tighten them all. So we'll start snugging them all down. Okay, so we torqued all the intake manifold bolts down to 15 foot-pounds. Gonna let it cure for a little while, and then I'll come back and do them all at 25. Since the battery was dying, you didn't get to see me tightening bolts, but I'm pretty sure by this point you know what that looks like. I couldn't really stop to deal with it since this is all... Intake manifolds are kind of stressful because it's a time-sensitive process with your RTV everywhere. You really have to have thread sealing. There's just a lot of little things, and things that are like intake manifolds can get kind of choosy about lining up just right. So a little bit stressful, don't love doing intake manifolds. And I just went around, checked the front and back seals to make sure it looks like it's sealed up tight, and it does. And wiped off any little excess bits of RTV that kind of squeezed out from the coolant ports. Okay, so all the intake manifold bolts are torqued to 30 foot-pounds. You want to do that in several passes and go over it all a couple times. Then I'm gonna come back in the morning in like 12 hours or so and retorque everything again. Ideally, you'd want to do it after you heat the engine up the first time or the first couple times, but it's really not going to be possible with the other equipment on here, so we're just going to torque it down to probably 32 foot-pounds and leave it be. And then we can put on the valve covers. So I went through and cleaned these up, knocked out the dents as much as I could, and just painted them. And it's not too bad. I don't know how it'll stand up, but it's fine. It's a lot better than it was. And I treated all the rust on them, so they shouldn't be too bad about that anymore. I'm just reusing the old gaskets. Same story for the other side. Different color gasket, because I did not replace this one, but it's okay. Don't worry about it. Okie dokie, it's looking like an engine again. Okay, so that's the main chunk of the engine assembled. What we're gonna do now is paint it. Now, I've never actually painted an engine before, and I've always kind of wanted to try it out. So, why not try it out on one that I don't really care too much about? So I have this Rust-Oleum enamel engine paint, and this is Chevy Orange, which just kind of worked out. It's gonna be a pretty obnoxious color. I was gonna have a more subtle color, but orange is my favorite, and this was the cheapest. So I'm not gonna do a crazy amount of prep. So yeah, it's not gonna be the best paint. It's probably gonna chip in spots and maybe fade, and maybe some of the fluids will take some of it off here and there, so it'll get kind of beat up looking and look kind of ratty, but it already does, really. And I've heard some things about this paint sticking to aluminum, but we're just gonna give it a go. So we're gonna paint it pretty much as is. Gonna pull off the valve covers, spray everything down real good with brake clean, wipe everything down, spray it down again, and then stick the valve covers back on, tape them up, tape up the oil pan, and make everything else orange. Some people don't like engines being painted fully assembled because then you have orange bolts and stuff, but that is the way GM used to do it, and I think it looks cool either way. It's my engine. I don't care. And it's also pretty cold outside. It's a little bit below the recommended, but hopefully it's close enough that it'll be okay. So I sprayed it off the brake cleaner again. I've got it sit down on wood here. It looks a little scary, but it's quite stable. It should be just fine. So for the stuff we need to mask off, I'm just using regular masking tape. With the hammer, all you're gonna do is tap along the sharp edge. It'll really just cut itself. Of course, you can use a rubber mallet or something too, but the hammer will get it done faster. And we'll just do that for everything that we need to mask off. Okay, so we've got things taped up fairly well, and it's fairly well cleaned up. And four coats later, here she is. I used around 2.5 cans doing the engine and the water pump. Since this is enamel paint, it has a long cure time, so I'm gonna have to give this a couple days. In the meantime, I'll try to go back and edit these videos and actually upload something. The next episode of this series will be bolting the last few things on this engine, throwing it back in the truck, and seeing what happens after that. We'll come over to the number one cylinder. That is the number one cylinder, isn't it? Yes. We'll come over to the... Oh, and yes. Never drive directly on the seal. Always have something between the hammer and the seal. Carefully drop the pan on. I was not careful. Appetizing. The cam came with a special packet of lube, and if your cam comes with something, you might as well use it. So we've got this Diablo brand cam lube. This stuff is probably pretty aggressive. I definitely need to wear the gloves to handle this, but it should help the cam break in perfectly. And just sort of coat each of the lobes with it. Oh yeah, that smells like a good product, all right. Rub all that in. Whew, gonna have to open the garage door for this one. Whoa. And then if we look at this guy. Uh-oh. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. And then if we look at this guy. It's no wonder these tools don't work.
Somebody keeps dropping them on the floor.
They seem to have disturbed his home.
Poor little guy. Don't worry, I'll take you somewhere safe. I'll put you in every commenter's bed, no problem.
When going through, I found four of these rotators were completely locked up. These had been soaked already in solvent. Oh! I found that three of these rotators were completely locked up. Oh shit, two of these rotators were completely... Take this guy back out. And drop it on the floor. And clean it back off.